Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Gopijana Vallabha Girivara Dhari Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Gopijana Vallabha Girivara Dhari Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana 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 Yamuna Tira Vanachari Tira Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Gopijana Vallabha Girivara Dhari Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Gopijana Vallabha Girivara Dhari Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Tira Vanachari Natira Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ramo Hare Ramo 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ramo Hare Ramo 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 Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Ramo Ramo, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Ramo Ramo, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Ramo Ramo, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Ramo Ramo, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Ramo Ramo, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Ramo Ramo, Hare Hare, Jayo Radha Madana Mohan Radha Madana Mohan Radhe Jayo Radha Madhavu Radha Madhavu Radhe Jayo Mahaprabhu, Jayo Mahaprabhu, Jayo Mahaprabhu, Jayo Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu. Jayo Lakshmi Narasimha, Jayo Ananta Dev, Jayo Lakshmi Narasimha, Jayo Ananta Dev, Jayo Lakshmi Narasimha, Jayo Ananta Dev, Jayo Lakshmi Narasimha, Jayo Jayo Gauranitai, Jayo Gauranitai, Jayo Gauranitai, Jayo Gauranitai, Gauranitai, Jayo Gauranitai, Jayo Gauranitai, Jayo Gauranitai, Jayo Jagannatha, Jayo Jagannatha, Jayo Baladeva, Jayo Shubhadra, Jayo Jagannatha, Jayo Jagannatha, Jayo Baladeva, Jayo Shubhadra, Jayo Krishna Balaram, 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 Jayo Vrindavana Dham, 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 Jayo Giri Govardhan, 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 Jayo Jayo Sita Rama Lakshman, Jayo Bhakta Hanuman, 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupad, 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 Jayo Jayo Prabhupad, Jayo Prabhupad, 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 Jayo Jayo Prabhupad, Jayo Jayo Prabhupad, 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 Jayo Jayo Prabhupad.
Srila Prabhupada ki, Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda ki, Gomata ki. Hare Krishna. So today we are discussing, welcome to Sunday Fish class, and I would like request all the blessings from the senior Vaishnavas, like we have Kanka Mataji, Balimardhan Prabhu and all Prabhupada disciples, and all assembled Vaishnavas here. So, and this is a very sensitive topic, as you know, the importance of cow protection, and cow is also called Gomata. So we will discuss like this agenda, like philosophy of why cow protection is very important, pastimes of the cow, and benefits of blessings of cow. We can say cow products, but scriptures, Shastra says it's not products, it's a blessings from the cow. And then we'll go to the implementation, practical implementation, how devotees, how Vaishnavas within our society can help or can involve into this topic. And before I go to the first step, we'll do the Mangalacharan prayers with all together. Thank you. Om Jnananda Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshun Nilitam Vena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Stapitam Vena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadandi Swapadandikam Vandeham Shri Gurum Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurum Vaishnavamsha
Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sagana Ragunatan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sagana Lalita Shri Vishakantam Cha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya De Satarine Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ramo Hare Ramo 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 Hare Hare Aradhyo Bhagavan Vrajesu Tanayas Taddhama Vrindavanam Ramyakachita Upasana Vrajvedu Vargena Kalpitam Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Prema Pumarto Mahan Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Mataidam Taddharana Paraha Satyam Vidatum Nijabrutya Bhashitam Vyaptim Chabuteshu Akileshu Chatmanaha Adrutya Adhyadbhuta Rupamudvahan Stambe Sabhayam Namrugam Namanusham Hare Krishna. Thank you. So, since it is a Bhagavad Gita class and we'll also discuss about co-protection in Bhagavad Gita. So, this is the important shloka which we, when we offer prasadam or bhoga to the Lord, we recite this prayer. Please repeat after me. Namo Brahmana Devaya.
Namo Brahmana
Devaya. Go Brahmana Hitaya cha.
Go Brahmana Hitaya.
Jagadhyayate
Krishnaya
Adhita Govindaya Namo Namaha. I offer my respectful obeisances unto the Supreme Absolute Truth Krishna, who is the well-wisher of the cows and the Brahmanas, as well as all living entities in general. I offer my obeisances to Govinda Krishna, who is the pleasure reservoir of all senses and especially the senses of his devotees. So, in this verse, you can see Krishna is emphasizing on only go. Go means cow, Gomata. So, and Brahmanas. First, we are offering obeisances to Brahmanya, that is Supreme Absolute Truth, that is Krishna. So, after that, Krishna is, we reciting this prayer, Krishna especially giving protections to, first to the cows and then Brahmanas. Why only cows? Anybody have any? This is an interactive seminar. It can be buffaloes, it can be goats, because Krishna used to have buffaloes, goats. When the forest fire happened in the forest, Krishna, it is in 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, all the buffaloes, all the goats also run away from the forest. But Krishna is especially talking about cows here. So you can, Prabhu, pass a mic. This is my notes. Please, anybody, why only cows? Please pass.
So, in cow's body, there are 33 crores demigods reside. That's the reason Krishna is emphasizing all the, you know, the animals. Amongst them, cow is the supreme.
Yes. Perfect. Thank you, Prabhu. So, yeah, that is one of the reasons Krishna is emphasizing on cow protection. Because cow is, we have seven mothers. Cow is one of them. And cow is also called Dhatri. You know, she is
she gives protection to the entire living entities, and by not only supplying milk, and cow have emotion, it having there are lot of many pastimes. I'll come to next couple of more slides. I'll talk about the pastimes, but cow especially will, you see, cow have four glands, two for the calf and two for the human beings. So Krishna, when he go to the Vrindavan, when you say Vrindavan, we'll only think about cows. It's called Goloka Vrindavan. Goloka means planet of cows. There is no Oracle or Genentech there, aware. So there only Krishna talks about cow, and because he personally set an example for us. What is in the Bhagavad Gita in 18th chapter, next sloka, it talks of Krushi Goraksha Vanijam Vaishyakarma Swabhavajam Paricharyatmakam Karmam Sudrashyamapi Swabhavajam, means farming, cow production and business are my natural works for the Vaishyas, and for the Sudras there is a labor and service to others. So Krishna here is mentioning Krushi Goraksha Vanijam, means Goraksha is specifically emphasizing on cow protection, not any other than cow or buffalo. He didn't talk about anything, just especially about cows, and is one of the main Vanijam, means business, trading. So in olden days there is no any other business except Brahmanas used to have, Nanda Maharaj used to have 10,000 cow or 90,000 cows. So like that, every caste of the society, the four Varnashram systems, everybody used to have cows. Kshatriyas used to have cows, Brahmanas used to have cows, Shudras used to have cows. Means, so Krishna is giving, in 18th chapter, is mentioning that we all have to, as a Vaishnavas, we all have a responsibility to protect the cows. It's not only for ISKCON devotees or any Vaishnava who considered as a devotee of Vishnu, he should protect the cows. That's what Krishna is giving an instruction to everybody. So this is I took some of the verses from the Srimad Bhagavatam, and we'll go in detail when in couple of more slides about the pastimes. So cow is our family member. You know, the you've seen Krishna in olden days, maybe in anybody traditional Indian, they have a goshala next to their house. And you can see cows, you can smell the cows. I was in a farm, I think 3 years before, in near Udupi, South India. There are more than 35 cows. Even the temple is made with cow dung. And when I went with one of my friend devotee, he said, I am unable to chant here because it's very silent. I need some sound to chant, because we are so conditioned here in this present fast-moving society. So Krishna here is in this picture. You can meditate on this picture. Krishna is mentioning is our family members, because we are all family members of Krishna. Cows are not maintained for aversion or its responsibility. It's our responsibility of a being. Vaishnava should protect cows. A Vaishnava is not only protect cows, but he also have protection, or he's having, he'll help all the living entities. But Krishna is pleased, then devotees are will be happy, so like that, asmat tushtit jagat tushtit, right? So Krishna is pleased by protecting the cows. So we feel bad when cows are killed and slaughtered. So in this 1 week, when I am preparing for this seminar, I understood many things. Like I learned many things, how the cow products we use, or we use generally our day-to-day life, the soaps, everything have contaminated with some of the animal fat. So this is the quote from Haribhakti Vilas by Sanatan Goswami. May cows stay in front of me, may cows stay behind me, may cows stay on both sides of me, may I always reside in the midst of cows. So people can interpret into many of these things. So you can, instead of cow, people can have cat. And it become like a trend, Sanatan Goswami is mentioning about only cows here. And he is not a sentimental statement. he is like our acharya, right? We have to follow him, but not putting cows next to it. As practically we have to follow that, we'll when we do the practical implementation. So from past 4 years I am taking only ahimsa milk. So when Prabhupada, anybody comes to new people, to the devotees, he never asked immediately to chant Hare Krishna. He asked first read books, then chant Hare Krishna. So if you have strong faith on philosophy, then you cannot deviate. So that's why Prabhupada also emphasized on all his purports. You know, in India, many, if anybody from North India or South India here, many towns and villages starts with Go. Gorakhpur, Govardhan, you know, Gokul, Nandagram, everything we start with Go. Go means it's cow. And they are emphasizing us to remember this. So, and even one of my devotee friends said, is Golconda used to call as Govulakonda before. So that become as Golconda. Why only cows? Because again, it's Krishna is emphasizing, Krishna is every day remembers cows. So this is from Srimad Bhagavatam. So passing from one part of the great forest to another, the goats, cows, buffaloes eventually enter an arena overgrown with a sharp canes. The heat of nearby forest fire made them thirst and they cried out of distress. See, in Srimad Bhagavatam, it talks about goats and cows. But Krishna emphasizes only on cow protection. Anybody knows how Krishna got name of Govinda? Who gave that name to Krishna? Sorry?
So after this Govardhan Leela,
yes.
So Indra has to take forgiveness from Krishna and he came, but he cannot come directly. So Surabhi was there. So Surabhi gave birth to Krishna with his milk, entire milk, and it became a kund. So because Krishna is favored to cows, so because of this cow's presence, Krishna is favored towards Indra. Otherwise directly he could not be favored because he did 7 days rain to Vrindavan Dham. So then his name was Govinda at the time. Yes, and Govind Kund is also there in Vrindavan.
Perfect. Thank you very much, Prabhu. Yeah, it comes in Srimad Bhagavatam in 10th canto. You can read about it. You can read in the purports. So Surabhi gave the name to Krishna as Govinda. Govinda means, go means cow and go means also senses. So who is the master of the cow? He is called Krishna. So anything do with the proper knowledge gives us conviction, faith and inspiration and the results of the process. So without proper knowledge, even I cannot do Srimad Bhagavatam distribution. So I have to read Srimad Bhagavatam, then I can distribute, right? At least not even end to end, but every day Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. If you just read 2 shlokas of Bhagavatam, and if you read continuously, you will get faith and conviction. So with that conviction, I can go and out distribute. As that, we also have to consume cow products. So if you have you have faith, then only you can consume it, right? So that's what, and here, it's from Srimad Bhagavatam. I have actually 200 slides out, only Prabhupada is talking about cow protection in all his books, in purports, in his lectures, in his conversations. But I don't go to in detail, but today I will just talk about the practical implementations and what we do as our society to protect this Go-mata. So this is the killing the demon Putana. Krishna kills Putana. After that, these gopis will, it comes in Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 6, 20. You can repeat after me. Gomutrena snapayitva punargo rajasarbakam raksham chakrushas chaskruta dvada sangashu namabhi. So here, anybody can read the purport, translation. Kuladi Prabhu can read. Yeah. It's in the second one, Mataji. The child was thoroughly washed.
The child was thoroughly washed with cow urine and then smeared with the dust raised by the movements of the cows. Then different names of the Lord were applied with cow dung on 12 different parts of his body.
The 10th canto, chapter 35. Okay, so I'll... So anybody can see this, right? It's a small font. So I need some volunteer to read the translation. Prabhu Balimardhan. Okay. So it's 19, okay, thank you, Prabhu. You can read the translation.
Mani dhara kochi daganayanga malaya daitya gandhatulashya pranayinu amu charashya kudamse prakshipam bhojam agataya agayata yatra kwanita venurava vanchita chittaha krishnam annashata krishna go grihivanya Guna Gunanam Anugatya Harinyo Gopikaiva Bhimukta Grihasha. Translation by Srila Prabhupada. Page down. Scroll down.
Translation.
Now Krishna is standing somewhere counting his own cows on a string of gems. He wears a garland of tulsi flowers that bear the fragrance of his beloved, and he has thrown his arm over the shoulder of an affectionate cowherd boyfriend. As Krishna plays his flute and sings, the music attracts the black deer's wives, who approach that ocean of transcendental qualities and sit down beside him, just like us cowherd gulls. They have given up all hope for happiness in family life.
Purport. Srila Jiva Goswami explains that in the afternoon, the Sri Krishna dressed himself in a new clothing and then went out to call the cows home. Srila Vishnu Chakravarti gives the following information about the transcendental cows of Vrindavan. For each of the four colors of cows, white, red, black and yellow, there are 25 subdivisions, making a total of 100 colors. And such a quality is being colored like a sandalwood pulp, tilak. Or having a head shaped like mrudanga drum, create 8 further groups. To count these 108 groups of cows, distinguish color, and Krishna is starting a string of 108 jewel beads. Thus, when Krishna calls out, "He Dhanavali," the name of white cow, a whole group of white cows come forward, and when he calls Hamsi, Chandini, Ganga, Mukta, and so on, the 24 other groups of white cows come. The reddish cows are called Aruni, Kunkuma, Saraswati, etc. The blackish ones, Shyamala, Dhumala, Yamuna, etc. And yellow ones, Pita, Pingala, Harita Tilaka, etc. Those in the group of the Tilaka marks where their foreheads are called Chitra Rata, Chitra Tilaka, Dirga Tilaka, and Trayaka Tilaka. There are groups known as Mrudanga Mukhi, Mrudanga head, Simha Mukhi, lion head, and so on. Thus, being called by name, the cows are come forward, and Krishna thinking that when it comes to bring them back from the forest, none should be forgotten. He is counting them on his jewel beads. So, such a beautiful purport. Krishna is not even forgetting one cow. He'll call out the cows by each name, and he's having we have a counting beads for our Japamala, right? So he's counting the cows for each group, it's in detail, I no need to explain about the purport. This picture you can see. Prabhu, back to me. Okay. Okay, thank you, bro. Wow. Okay. Now, Nanda Maharaj used to have 900,000 cows. Vishwanath Chakravarti gives the description of the cows of Vrindavan. Krishna known every cow by name. If any cow was missing, Krishna would immediately chase after the missing cow and call her by name. The cows are divided into the herds by color and either by black, white, red or yellow. So you see, Lord Krishna is here is setting an example. To teach by example, the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna and Lord Balaram show us the descendant into this world. How important is to protect, love and serve the cows and bulls. Krishna is known as Gopal, protector of the cows, as Govinda, one gives pleasures to the cows. Lord Balaram represents plowing the land of agriculture and there always carries a plow. His hand, whereas Krishna tends cows and therefore carries a flute in his hand. Thus the two brothers represents Krishi Raksha, protecting bulls by engaging them in the farming. Go Raksha, protecting the cows. So this comes from Srimad Bhagavatam again, Canto 10, Chapter 5, 20 purport. So in here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying Adi Leela chapter 17 text 111 say in my last birth I was born in a family of a cowherd man and give the protection to the calves and cows. Because of such a pious activities I have now become the son of a Brahmana. So Prabhupada mentions in the words of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the greatest authority here, clearly indicates that one becomes pious simply by keeping cows and protecting them. Unfortunately, people have become such a rascals that they not even care about the words of an authority. So it's not my words, it's still Prabhupada's words. So I think Kanka Mataji knows this picture. Srila Prabhupada was in Gitanagari. So these all Prabhupada quotes, I'll just read them and then we'll go to the couple of pastimes of cow. So cow protection means feeding the Brahmanical culture which leads towards God consciousness and the perfection of human civilization is achieved. Without cow protection of cows, Brahmanical culture cannot be maintained. And without Brahmanical culture, the aim of life cannot be fulfilled. One cannot become spiritually advanced without acquiring the Brahmanical qualification and giving protection to the cows. So this is from Srila Prabhupada. I'm continuing the quotes for next two more slides. Prabhupada says in Hawaii in the January 1974. So in this movement for one program is to respect the cows. We chant this mantra, Namo Brahmana Devaya Go Brahmanitaya Cha. The Brahmanical culture and the cows, why they have a selected cows? There are so many animals. Why co-protection is so important in Krishna consciousness? Why Krishna personally himself become a cowherd boy and was taking in the care of the cows and the calves? Oh, that is very essential. So there is four pillars of our Indian or any Vaishnava or any, you can say entire world, universe. So there are four terms. One is Gomata, Gayatri and Gita, and one more is Ganga. This all starts with Ga, right? So this Gomata, this is considered as a four pillars of for Dharma. So if there is no Dharma, Krishna won't be there. And Krishna will Dharma Samstarpan Arthaya Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. He came to establish Dharma and he is, you can see the pillars of the Dharma, you can see the picture inside here, which talks about these four pillars of Dharma. And this is a Kamadenu picture. You can see all demigods which is residing in the cow. And cow also is called a moving deity. You can worship the cows. There are many, many pastimes. I will come to that now. You see, Brahmadev is there in the hump of the cow and Lakshmi Devi is in the back of the cow. Narada Muni is there and Vishnu and Lord Shiva Everybody residing in the cow. If anybody have been to Simhachalam, there is in South India a couple of temples where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went and Prabhupada went. All devotees also go to the South India Yatra, visit these temples. They before have darshan to the people, normal people, they will show cow back to the Lord. So I personally seen in the temple called Ahobilam when I went recently to India. So they bring the cow. Without saying anything, the cow shows the back to the Lord Narasingadev because Lakshmi Devi is residing in the cow. That's why cow urine and gobar, it's not actually gobar, it's called govar, right? So it's the blessings of the cow. So only there are two people are in this like Krishna creation are eligible to wear the peacock feather. One is Krishna and two is cow. So you see, normally any other personality or expansion of Krishna, nobody cannot wear a peacock feather except mother cow and Krishna, because Krishna is pleased when we protect the cows. You can see, this is when I went this time to India, my hometown is very famous for cows, where I belong to, near Tirupati. But unfortunately now they also send the cows for slaughter houses, because if cows and bulls are not engaged, they immediately send. Every week there are 200 cows goes. So my father, I forced him to buy 2 cows when I went, and he said, "Oh, it's very difficult. It's like a baby. I have to maintain." So many excuses. But I said, you know, if you have cows, then it is like deity living at your home, and devatas will come and worship your home if cow resides. So then he agreed, and we bought this cow. Her name is Lakshmi. And recently, 2 weeks before or 3 weeks before, this cow, they put a bore pump, like a lot of machinery in my area. So he got scared and left from my home, or our farm actually. And they searched the whole night. They didn't find this cow. And finally, in the morning around 5 o'clock, they found this cow in a well. It's actually a pregnant cow. But fortunately, it's all Krishna's mercy, and nothing happened to the cow. And they got the JCP, you know, they put the mud in the well. It's a dry well, and it's nothing in the well. There are, if you see the well, right, India having like different stones. But this cow fall in a place, in a safest place, not even a scratch to the cow. And in the morning we went, and it came running to my father, and they put the you know, hot water just to bathe the cow because it's scared, and the doctor came and saw even the baby in the cow, it's good. So because cow is very, very emotional. See, it's also it's considered as one of the family member. Why? Because in olden days, or now also, if anybody fights in the family, husband fights with the wife. So it recommended that wife should not give breast milk to the baby, because the emotion adds to the baby. And it's in one of the past instance, the one baby died because she became so emotional and she fed the baby. And that's why the cow also, it's very, very emotional. I'll just to tell the two pastimes. This is like Lord Venkateshwara pastime. Anybody have been here to Tirupati? Rajesh, many people, yes. Yeah, Balaji name is also called Balakrishna. So Prabhupada went there, and he was there in Tirupati, and he spoke with many delegates there, and they do the cow protection also, Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanams. So before Balaji was there, he was in Vaikuntha, and he came back to Buloka, and Lakshmi Devi also came down, because she came earlier before Balaji. Actually, she was in the place called Kolhapur. Is also Lakshmi Devi temple is there. But Balaji was very thirsty, and he's fasting because he's in separation of Lakshmi. And he came to the 7 hills, is called Seshachalam now. And he was in the ant hill meditating on Lakshmi. And he's starving, and Brahma and Shiva and everybody worried that Supreme Personality of Godhead doesn't have any food, and he's a Govinda, he drinks milk every day. and Lord Brahma become as a cow, and Lord Shiva become as a calf. And they came, and they came to the local king there in Chandragiri. There is a small hometown nearby. And at that time, the king, okay, it's a very beautiful cow, I'll buy this. And it gives a very fine grain milk, and you can have it. The king thought very, okay. Lakshmi Devi personally sells to the king. And she sells with a good price, not even lot of amount. And the queen thinks that, okay, I bought this cow and we should make out of it. And, you know, we should take all the milk and use for all our deity worship or whatnot. But every day this cow is going and not coming with any milk. So he said, there's something wrong here. And he called the cowherd man and he said, you know, if you cannot bring the milk today, I'll kill you. So it's king's order. So he went with the axe in the hand and say, if this cow doesn't give milk, I'll kill the today. So he thought like that and he went to this ant hill. And whenever this cow went to the ant hill, it started pouring the milk to the Krishna, Balakrishna. He started drinking the milk. And you see the axe in the hand of this person here. And he throwed the axe on the cow, but Krishna is Bhakta Vatsala. He came out of the ant hill and hit exactly on the forehead of Krishna. So that's why Krishna also puts, now it's like a Urdhva Pundaram, it's called a tilak mark on his forehead, because he got the hit of the axe here. And the first person in the Kali Yuga, he saw that they are also called Yadavas. In traditional language. So now also in Tirumala Tirupati, in temple, morning they give the Navanitam for the Lord, Makkan. Around 2:30 if you go, they give a big pot of the milk. I went one time for Suprabhata Darshanam, and they also distribute this. Because he is Balakrishna, and you can smell, when inside the temple, you can smell the milk, fragrance in the temple. So this is one of the pastime, and by this understanding, these stories sticks to our heart. That means Krishna is emphasizing on how to protect cows. So there are a couple of more pastimes. One time, you know, anybody heard about Raghavendra Swami? He is also one of the Madhva Sampradaya. He is a saint. So at that time, there is in India, in even Mayapur, they used to attack with a lot of these dacoits, you know, thieves. They are like comes as a 40-50 people and attacks some area and they will go away. So these dacoits came and they are actually looting all the villages in South India. And they came to one place actually, and the dacoit leader, he was very hungry. And he want to kill, he's a Muslim, and he want to eat something. So they saw this cow, one cow, having a calf inside, it's a pregnant cow. And the dacoits, all friends, right, they arrested this cow. Arrested and they put a ties for the cow. And the cow is laying, they are about to kill the cow with the knife. But somehow or other this cow looked at the person, that leader. And he was looking at them, and he looked in a very compassionate, you know, see, please save me, and like that. And but when this leader thought about his wife, she's also pregnant, and okay, let me save this cow, I'll relieve this cow. And she cut the rope of the cows, which is tied to the legs. The cow went away. And then they went away. After maybe 20 years, this dacoit group got arrested. And it's the British is ruling our country at that time. So they got arrested of that dacoit leader, and he got a life sentence. They put a rope for, and he had to die, right? So the date came, and exactly on that morning, whenever he was supposed to hang him, so he put a they put a rope for his neck, and you know, you've seen like how they hang, right? They put platform. Yeah. So if you do three times, right? So the person doesn't die. That means they will relieve him. So first time they did it, he didn't die. Second time they did it, they removed the platform, he didn't die. Third time they didn't. So according to British law, if you do three times, if he still survives, let him go. They relieved him. And everybody asks, it's documented. I done research, enough research, and also anybody knows, Madan Gopal Prabhu told me this story from Chaupati. So when they removed the platform, the cow came in the bottom, and his legs was there on the cow. Three times it came like that. And as soon as he relieved from the jail, coming outside, this cow was waiting to see him. And the cow is crying when he sees him. See, on the day you saved me, now I saved you. So, I mean, cow have emotion. It's not a, that's why it's called Dhatri, and that's why it's called Gomata. We just won't protect cows by like some low things we are protecting. I gave donation for cow protection. No, cow protection is not done with the compassion. It should done as our responsibility. So, so there are even Srila Prabhupada here further quotes, without protecting cows of Brahmani culture cannot be maintained. The bull helps in the agriculture process of producing grains, etc. And thus, one sense of bull is a father and human father of humankind, whereas cow is the mother for the supplies milk to the human society. A civilized man therefore expect to give all protection to the bulls and cows. So there is also one of the recent pastime in Narmada, the banks of Narmada, one person actually retired from in Vanaprastha state. He went there, he want to live his life. He's a go rakshaka, he's a go sevaka. Yes. And you know, right, who he are from his life, he's protecting only cows. So he was taking, he built his own hut, and he's in the hut every day. He used to offer the, whenever he cook a food, he first thing he'll offer it to the cow. So this cow, every day coming at the noon time, and but he's having just some savings, that is, his kids are some working in somewhere, they are sending some money to him, and he's just saved some money, but he doesn't lock his hut. He just woke, because in India, right, so he never locked his house, he went away like that. But one day cow came early around 9 o'clock, and he didn't understand why this came. It should come around noon time, I don't have nothing to offer, but he got some fruits, and he went to offer the fruits, but cow didn't take anything. So he said, okay, let me, I want to go for a japa walk. So he thought he want to go out of his home, but cow didn't allow him. And he want to go from back of the door, cow still came to the back door. At the same time, around 10 o'clock, one person came, and from the window he put a hand, and he's taking all the Lakshmi away for what he saved that money. So cow knows your feelings. You know, Balabhadra Prabhu, anybody know, is a cow protection minister. For our ISKCON society. So he went to India, to Tirupati, and he is having a farm in New Vrindavan. Every day he brushes the bulls, he brushes the cows, and he serves the cows every day. His main business, he can talk to cows actually, such a elevated personality. And when he came, he went to a farm near in Tirupati. That farm actually owned by Tirumal Tirupati Devasthanams. One bull came running to Balabhadra Prabhu, and he started crying. And the Revati Raman Prabhu, the temple president of Tirupati, he was next to him, said, why this cow is crying? I said, I have some connection with the bulls. So you see, this she is our mother, and every child have responsibility to protect the cow. So that's why we are, so you see, just cow doesn't slaughtered for the beef. Cow slaughtered for many reasons. This I just put together is a picture I took in Pandharipur temple, ISKCON temple. Maybe it's very difficult to see, but I can say from cow is killed for four things. You know, cow leather, cow blood, cow bones, and this every products we use every day, like a Dove soap, right? Dove soap contains this object called tallow. It comes from the fat of the cow, you know, the beef or fat of the cow. So I done, like, you know, from 3 days I'm doing this research. Not only within Vaishnava society, outside people also they won't use these soaps, which is the commercial products. So you can see on the picture, made from the boiling animal, and also it's a byproducts. It's called from animal slaughterhouses, called tallow. Can in every commercial soaps you can see this product. And I see devotees sometimes say, Prabhuji, I want to chant Hare Krishna, why you are going into in detail? No, it's Krishna is very sensitive. right? You know, Krishna and Krishna system, Shakti, Shaktiman, right? So both are very important, and Krishna is very, very sensitive. And we should go in detail, especially, for example, you are doing Ekadashi Rath, and we done Bhishma Panchak also, 5 days. Balimardhan Prabhu requested everybody to do it. So I also done it. In the morning, you put this bone powder into the mouth in Brahma Muhurta time. We woke up 4 o'clock. This Colgate, whatever toothpaste you are using, every product have a, directly or indirectly, it having a beef, because it's very inexpensive. People will slaughter the cows, and we maybe directly won't slaughter, but we are using it, we are consuming it. And you put this bone powder into the mouth, and we won't get the trupti, we won't get the taste. That's why when we have this prasadam, we'll ask more, you know, yeah, more samosa, more gulab jamun, whatever it's. We ask more because we don't find the trupti in part. So there are these commercial soaps which I am mentioning. Every soap have one byproduct. So this is called sodium tallow, and this is the one. They put a name which we cannot understand. So we go to Costco and buy for 1 year. I was talking to one person, he said, from past 15 years I'm using this soap. And I'm sorry, it's very sensitive, and it's every devotee have their own opinion. But this fact, Prabhupada emphasized, Prabhupada just doesn't come to just open temples. Prabhupada having higher vision, and he told 50% of my work is not done. 50% of Varnashram system he have to establish. Prabhupada emphasized it everywhere. Even Prabhupada is leaving his body, and he came to Geetanagari. He's supposed to come to Geetanagari, but he stayed in London because his health was very sick. And he said, I will go to the farms. I will show how to protect cows. Personally, he documented it. I also have a video. But why I am saying, see, these are some of the facts. I have this website, I can give these links, you can talk to me offline. Mostly cow fat contains this object and called tallow or bone powder, whatnot. And even the cow blood, right? So the people, when my wife was pregnant, they gave prenatal, right? Before everybody gives. But most of this they make it with this cow blood. So we should be very, very careful. And that's why you see the younger kids, they get eyes, I'm not a doctor, but I can see practically by Ayurveda, you look at it. Every very young age, they get the eyes, the spectacles for the kids, because they use this called these products, and they are, one drop of cow blood can, Prabhupada said, can enter America and Europe and India, everything will go away just for this abnormal or which is, you can say, cow killing. So, and this is, you see, here also we have a form, right, is Surabhi cow. Just they won't have, cow lifespan is for 25 years, actually lifespan, but because of the meat industry or commercial industry, it will live only for 7 years. And as soon as the calf born, they will take away next day itself. So they won't keep the calf. And without the calf of the cow, how can cow can milk give a milk? And we are just like Arjuna says in Bhagavad Gita, right? First chapter, with the tinge of the blood, I am enjoying this kingdom. How can I enjoy like that? We are enjoying this opulence of Krishna's opulence, and we are claiming that, you know, I am doing my devotional service. So this is the commercial products I found, which is all these products have, especially Dove, have the object of cow fat. So which is comes especially for how. And also cosmetics and chocolates, Kit Kat also have this products of cow products. So even Nestle, good food, good life. So how anybody knows how Nestle came? It's a very demonic company. They started in Europe, and they hired all these young college girls, and they made them as nurses. And every commercial company have food nutrition company have their own sister company of drugs. Why? Because you eat this food and you will become sick and you will take their products. It's actually the connection between this. And I see in Glasgow, or what is that company? Yeah, so they have food products and also they have nutrition products. So this, everything is interconnected, and even McDonald's. So McDonald's major revenue in India, they take that money and they buy beef and they export to United States. And India is the toppest exporter of the beef. And most of the slaughterhouses owned by government, and only two slaughterhouses are owned by like Muslims in India. And majorly, they just won't kill it for the milk. And even you may see the leather is very soft. Only the calf leather is very, very soft. We become old, our skin becomes soft. But cow and calf is, from the initial age itself, the cow is, the skin is very soft. And they export from Kerala to London. And they make the cloths for the people. I'm sorry, because this is the fact, and we have to discuss this. This one of the disadvantages. Now we come to the blessings of the cow. It's called also gober or gover. So cow urine, cow dung. In cow urine, Ganga Devi resides. That's why you can have cow urine. It having many, like in Haridwar, I heard recently they are, instead of Pepsi, Coca-Cola, people drinking, right? They're selling cow urine as a drink. So because cow urine have many advantages for it, not only the external things like our body equilibrium will be good. Not only that, it also helps. Cow is a very emotional object, that's why it's called Gomata. And in the cow dung, Lakshmi Devi resides. So even they continue on the cow bless. So we have devotion on cow, but knowledge is lacking. So everybody is not sentimental. It should be like a responsibility for all dude. All we have bhakti, but very weak knowledge on the, and we cannot develop the gratefulness if don't know who they are. So that's why we have to educate ourselves by going into in detail, and by that we can understand. So, and we can use these panchagavya products like cow ghee, cow urine, cow milk, cow curd, and cow dung. These all called panchagavya products. If anybody fasted for Bhishma Panchak, so these five things, one day, panchagavya we will offer to Lord Damodara, and then used only one time we can honor it. So I didn't find cow dung here because it should be properly kept it. So that's why I fasted the second level of fast. You can see cow urine also. Even every day morning before it's my personal experience, I drink the cow urine. And my health is, I go every week for book distribution. So I don't feel tired. I'm not promoting this product, but I'm sharing my personal experience with all of you. So this is the lot of scientific things here. Just by cow urine, how many things we can develop. It's very, font is very small, but I can read for you some. It's also called cow urine products. So each in detail, it can use it for your bones. It's used for your body equilibrium, and it should be a distilled cow urine. And it never spoils. And when I went to India, I got some cow urine bottles with me. And my friend also who came, he got a full box of products. And the immigration, they stopped him and they checked it, what it is. And we explained this, our traditional, that we drink this, and they let him go. And we also have ahimsa milk. So Prabhupada also says, it also prolongs ahimsa milk. Life develops his brain, execute devotional service, and ultimately attain the favor of Supreme Personality of Godhead. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 8, Chapter 6, and Text 12. And ahimsa milk is particularly essential for developing for the finer tissues of human brain, so that one can understand the intricacies of transcendental knowledge. How can milk, if you drink milk, how can I understand spirituality? Prabhupada said, if you boil the milk, and you know, people nowadays, they are deficiency of iron, many things, right? Some people, I personally, so many people excuse, oh, my kid doesn't drink ahimsa milk. You have to pasteurize it. You have to boil it in a iron kadai, right? In India, they boil it with. So when you boil with iron utensils, iron comes automatically. You don't need to take any byproducts for that. So, and also Dhanvantri. It's called ghee, also is called gritam. And so there are many benefits of cow, if you can read this, but I will go. In the Kartik month is first comes Lakshmi Puja. From if anybody Diwali they celebrates and also some people also celebrate Lakshmi Ganesh. I don't know how that combination came. Please don't ask me that. But they worship that, and usually our devotees we do the Lakshmi Puja. After that mainly ISKCON Vaishnavas we call those Govardhan Puja. From Govardhan Puja after that comes Gopashtami. After Gopashtami is come Tulsi Vivah. So all these four products comes as Dhanvantri. You see this picture? Dhanvantri is also called a doctor for all devatas. And he is also a doctor for Krishna. So in a there is a temple in Srirangam near Tiruchi. One time Ranganath got a, because they offered yogurt and some fruits together to the Lord Ranganath. And Ramanujacharya came and saw that Ranganath is sick, he's coughing and he's having cold. And he went and told, go and get a aushad from Dhanvantri. There is a temple next to the Ranganath temple, it's called Dhanvantri temple. Now also they give this medicine. If any have any skin diseases or anything, you can just take this cow medicine which is made with all these Panchagavya products. So, and that's after this Lakshmi Puja, Govardhan, Gopashtami, Tulasi Vivah, and also it adds the Tulasi ingredients. So, use these cow products, and by consuming it, you are supporting it. How consuming can be supporting? So, because there is a Goshala, Bhakti Raghava Maharaj, he visited recently. So it's called Patameda. They make all the go products. They have 1,25,000 cows. And it's in the border of Rajasthan and Pakistan. Just only one sadhu, or they have 5,000 acres of land. Every day they put Om Surabhyaya Namaha, Om Surab, that mantra, right? So every day they put for the cows. And cows so feel happy, and without going for milking, it automatically gives them milk. And all our ISKCON temples where I visited, Pune and Mumbai and Tirupati, all the temples, they are shipping these cow products themselves, and the devotees are using it. And they also, you are traveling, you don't have a milk, ahimsa milk, you can use Patameda. There is a product where you can cow the powder, right? You can make it as milk. Like that, there is lot of options available. Today also I brought, and we also have a booth. Vinay Prabhu, Bhagavati Mataji will be there. There are many cow products which daily use. You can use it. This is called cow soap, which is made with the Panchagavya products. And also this is also different soap. One for Mataji's, one for Prabhuji's. You know, one time in the Independence Day parade, I was waiting for Vaisheshika Prabhu, and Vaisheshika Prabhu came with one of the devotee from Berkeley, and Vaisheshika Prabhu introduced me. He's Purushottam, like that, and he said, "I know him. Wo sabun bechta hai." So I ran away from there, and Prabhu called me. I said, "What is sabun?" He asked. So there is nothing wrong here. Sabun means soap. I told Prabhu, then I gave to Prabhu also. Prabhu also uses. So this is very even if there is some soap or small things, but this means small things. Krishna, as I told you, is very very sensitive, and he doesn't like you. Even you offer 1,008 offering to Krishna with a processed food, how can Krishna will be pleased? And he sees, as I told you, even in Haribhakti Vilas, it says that you pluck the flower, it having some, you cannot offer that flower. I mean, we all does every day that. But he is a Bhavagrahi Janardana, he take the essence. But we should be very, very careful when we deal with this everyday things. And also, there are many, cow products, I'll show you in mic. So I have a small video presentation. I'll present it now. And there is a three, and not only devotees. Krishna said, if Krishna wants it, outside people also. Now there are many organizations protecting cows here within United States. So I will just show you these three examples, which is it shows one is the cow emotional, how important this cow production. This is a video I just took a small 5 minutes video, which okay.
We have become totally disconnected with the basis and the pillars of Dharma, which are cows. Dharma begins with the protection of cows. When we cut out, you know, when we become disconnected with cows, as we have, in the cities, living in the cities means we are disconnected with cows. We no longer look after cows, we no longer see cows, we no longer think about cows, we no longer care about cows. If we no longer care about cows, what's Krishna going to care about us? Isn't it? Krishna is constantly meditating on his cows. Krishna worships every day his cows. Krishna cannot live without cows. How can we manage to live without cows? The Brahminical culture cannot be established without cows. Krishna consciousness cannot be practiced without cows. How are we managing to practice our Krishna consciousness without cows? We must ask ourselves these questions.
So this is from Bhakti Rao Maharaj. Recently also when Maharaj was in a Hebri farm, one cow is actually, it's not even is our farm cow. This cow just came to Maharaj and he licked his back, his neck, and as I told you, its cow is very, very emotional. So you can just see this 1 minute or 2 minutes video. It's also about how cow is very emotional. It's like Gomata. There is no video, but they just took a picture. This is a farm near Udupi. Vaisheshika Prabhu also visited one time when in his last South India Yatra. This is a Prabhupada Vyasasan. They're planning to construct a small temple with the all cow ingredients will be the temple objects. So this is a temple. I also stayed there. The devotees wash the utensils with the cow dung, and their soap is cow dung. So this is a cow which is came from outside, and there is no internet connection. Maharaj was checking emails on the top of a hill. So this cow just came and was with Maharaj for some time. Just do the neck massage. massage back to the neck. Joined our temple actually. The experience with this cow gave me a glimpse into the Vrindavan must be like Krishna and Balaram. If we start giving time, we can start dealing with personally Vedan, them to Krishna as friends. So back to the seminar. If you see, as I told you, if Krishna wants it, the outside devotees are doing. In Dallas, Texas, there is a person called Alan Savory. He started the Gazing Lands. And he is also having a website. I just took one small video from his website. You can see he is giving seminars all over the world. By cow protection, you can maintain your economy. No need any other things. So
did you know our grasslands are turning to desert? These grasslands that are so important for life. They hold soil in place, store water, store carbon, and feed billions of life forms. One-third of the Earth's land surface faces the threat of desertification. Imagine the impact of losing our grasslands on civilization, on the Earth. What if I told you that we had the power to change it? But to change it, we must understand it.
Please come.
Imagine a world
forward,
of large
please.
Herds of caribou, buffalo, and other grass-eating species migrating over the lands with their predators. The soils, plants, and animals developed together and lived in balance. Large herds grazed, defecated, stomped, and salivated on the land, which built soil and deepened plant roots. Over time, however, these wild herds have almost entirely disappeared and have been replaced with a low number of sedentary livestock. This disrupted the balance of birth, growth, death, and decay. Grasslands depend on biological decay to survive. And without it, desertification persists. Desertification has long been blamed on overgrazing, too many cattle, sheep, and goats. Although not backed by science, this belief led to human policies and technologies to control desertification, such as removing animals and rejuvenating grasses with fire, further contributing to the problem. Wildfire does offer short-term benefits by removing dead material to allow new green flush. It also destroys soil cover and puts carbon into the air, causing long-term damage. Destocking animals allows the land to rest, but overrest inhibits biological decay and can lead to fires. The process must be biologically active. Grass needs animals to thrive. Recently, we discovered that the problem can be reversed with the very thing on which it has been blamed, herds of livestock. A new form of management that mimics the natural behavior of wild herds and restores the balance that once was. This can be done through holistic planned grazing. With a holistic approach, the cycle can take place, the grasslands can be healed, people can thrive, and the earth can be restored. Plants, animals, and soils developed together. Only when our approach to livestock management mimics nature will our grasslands begin to thrive. Under the research and direction of Alan,
He doesn't do only for the money, but he wants people, and he supports the community. And this cow arrived just in Kartik month. So His Holiness Bhakti Raghav Maharaj gave, and we requested Maharaj to present her a name. So Maharaj gave as Surabhi, because before Deepavali, on one day before Deepavali, the Surabhi arrived in Vrindavan. So there is a story about that in sacred book I have in my bag. Actually, we are ordering more of those books. So you can read about that pastime. Krishna want to drink some milk, and the cow arrived at that time. That cow name is called Surabhi. So Maharaj also named this cow as Surabhi. And you know, devotees, before we bought this cow, we went to the different farms. I visited one farmer, and I asked that lady, she is protecting cows, and I asked, what you do with the milk? Because she won't sell for the dairy, and or she won't take herself also. She takes maybe little bit and for a family. But in the cow shed, next to that, there is a big pig. So he said, whatever comes milk extra, she is giving to pig. So as we don't have milk here, but the pigs are becoming fat just drinking that cow milk. I'm sorry. So that's a fact. And here, especially in United States, those they have extra milk, and cow should be actually milked immediately because it can die, right? So he is emphasizing only on cows. So this is, and also create a farm to temple. Even Prabhupada have a concept of this Govinda restaurants, right? So Govinda means we should have our own farm, produce our own things, and distribute it. We should not buy like other people, go to Costco or Whole Foods, we buy organic food and cook in the... It becomes again a restaurant. We may offer to Krishna, but the real thing, every temple, that's why this is the Laguna Beach ISKCON DDO farm. This only one farm supports two temples. It's actually in between Laguna Beach and San Diego. Devotees, brahmacharis go in the Saturday, and it gives all the summer they are saving more than $2,000 every month as an expenses. So they no need to buy everything, potatoes, all comes from the farm. And they also got 2-3 cows. Tukaram Prabhu is the manager, managing that project. And the fresh flowers for Krishna, they are offering from that cow. And this is 2 cows they recently bought. And all the products they are coming to Krishna is by these 2 farms, one farm actually. And create farm to temple, New Vrindavan. New Vrindavan also have cows, and they make ghee, butter, chas, and you know, all cow ingredients. And also Gita Nagari, our main farm project, everybody knows about it. And they also got certified with local all markets, like Whole Foods. They are selling ghee, paneer, and clarified butter to these farms. And adjust for the demand. Option 1, accept only cruelty-free milk. As I told you, if you ask for it, if you take a personal vow, it's again, as I told you, it's a sensitive topic. It's for individual devotees, they may say it's expensive. But we are not just, we are pleasing Krishna by taking cow products. And we are pleasing Gomata, and you are saving some cows to not go to slaughterhouse by just consuming these products. So this is Vaisheshika Prabhu also doesn't take any milk, like which is Himsa milk. He only takes Ahimsa milk. And Bhakti Raghav Maharaj, Bhakti Vikas Maharaj, and also Balimardhan Prabhu said, and Gopal Krishna Maharaj, many sannyasis, Radhanath Maharaj, when they travel, they use only Ahimsa milk. Why? It's again, if you, as I told you, in Ekadash, they also put, I had done some research in the milk, they put fish oil in it. So because the milk may become thicker, or you know, and babies or kids will take our second generation this milk, and you know, and we offer that to Krishna and say, please accept it. Krishna doesn't accept, because Prabhupada, when Prabhupada time, at that time there is no farms. Prabhupada may said, you know, you may use it, but Prabhupada never said that you can buy from like dairy and offer to Krishna. But in emergencies, if you don't have any exceptions for the babies, you can use it. But
look for opportunity, and currently in our temple we have ahimsa milk. You can take this opportunity and expand this and help. You can help in not only by buying it, you can go and serve the cow weekly once. You can wash the cow, you can brush the cow, you can milk the cow, and not milking like Indian style. So you can, here they won't allow, unfortunately. But I'm saying there are many other ways you can do it. When I told Maharaj that I'm taking organic vegetables in the farm, we are getting from this live earth farm, Maharaj said, you go help them. I said, no Maharaj, I don't help because I do other service. And I said, you have to, then you are more accustomed to eat organic food. It's not, you should help, this cow protection means we should help, involve and consume this cow product. So this is the, and the second option is, first option, accept only cruelty-free dairy, and second option is also is use only cow products. As I told you, I got cow urine. This is also hair oil. One week before I spoke with one of the Indian spice bazaar, the owner, he said, I'll ship as many cow products you want. I'll help you on this project. We are shipping many things in Dubai temple. They are shipping banana leaves for the temple. You know, we are in Bay Area, not in anywhere in the East Coast or anywhere where there is climatic conditions. Here we have everything. If you go to Indian store, everything is available. But I never saw a cow products like this available because we don't have demand for it. So if you ask, when there is a demand, there will be a supply. I have a testimonial. Ananda Mataji, I gave this, what is called? It's called a hair shampoo for the head. I'm not promoting only which I have this product. I'm promoting any goshala you can use. You can go to India, you can get your own products, or you can work with me or work with Hariguru Prabhu. We can get for you. Mataji, you want to share? Some mic. We have 5-10 more minutes, then we'll go for Kirtan.
Hare Krishna. We are using the soap and the hair tonic and some other things what Prabhuji gave, shampoo, all the cow products, and that seems like good. So I think it will be helpful if everybody takes it and use it.
Yeah.
And it's fully like from cow itself. Like you can smell the cow dung in it and everything. Right.
So thank you, Mataji. Yes. Ramanand Sakaprabhu, have some.
So we hear about all these products and we also say that if we ask for it, there'll be a supply. But first, the supply is, even information about where the supply is there is not even available mostly.
Right, right.
So can you
sure.
just send us some information on where we can get these products?
Yes.
So that is the thing that will help a lot
it's
of
called
devotees.
Go, thank you, Prabhu. It's called goseva.org. They have a goshalas all over India, especially they send from Kanpur goshala. They sell all these products, and every cow urine, you can say on this, right? Any of this, it says every product you buy, it saves a cow. And what they do is they get ingredients from their own farm, and it's there, that farm, and they made also video. I'll share with in ISKCON SV General. There they make these products, and it is available for everybody. And also they sells to our temples. And if you go any Pune or any ISKCON temple, you can find this product. And they also have website.
So, but those website, if you order it, they'll ship to America?
But that's what we have to work it out. Okay. We can ship to the local Indian store and we can buy it for the temple, or that in detail, Prabhu, that we can work it out. That's not a problem. Currently, what I am doing for myself, I am paying more in the airport, bringing one suitcase of soaps and cow products for my consumption, and I give it to my friends and like that.
So, just like we did for Ahimsa Milk project, we got cow, and there is now Ahimsa Milk available.
Yes.
Now people can get it.
Yes.
Now similarly, if there is something like that where people can buy things locally.
Correct.
Instead of worrying about you know, about the whole system.
Correct.
That's what will really help.
So, and also Ramanand Prabhu request, we need who can make cow soaps, please contact. So, Prabhupada wants this actually. Prabhupada wants a land and he wants the devotees work in the land.
No, I am not asking that we make it ourselves.
Yeah.
We just need to get them and make it available.
Okay, yes, Prabhu. We can work out with the local farmers and get that available. But this is, I want to make it available if on demand. So we can work with the Indian stores and get that. So I didn't finish it. Then we'll go to questions. So how can, this is a cow products, as it's available outside. You can enroll it, and if you want, there is also make with tablets, and as go mutram is there, and cow soaps, danta manjan, you know. I gave it to one American or Western devotee in the Radhayatra form. So Radhayatra, he came, and then we put a table. 2 years he is coming and taking, and last time he gave a testimonial. He said that my teeth, you know, even it looks black, this powder, right? But it is, I am feeling better. I have a toothache, it's gone. And is there any way I can buy like that? He said, come next year for the yatra, I'll give you. So the thing is, we can make it available, but we need a demand for it. If anybody asks supply, we can put it in a website. And there is also a website already there, but I'll let you know the details. So how you can support, please take your own personal vows. Consume cow products, support Sorabhi project, and please contact ISV devotees, Hari Guru Prabhu or myself, Bhagavati Mataji, or many devotees here. So, and also be involved in this project. That's all I have in today's presentation. So these are some websites. You can visit cowcare, varnashrama.com, Varnashrama books, what ministry sites, Krishna cows and make Vrindavan villages like that. So, Gomata ki, Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupad ki. So we have 5 minutes for questions, if anybody have any questions.
What you said that many of the brand name soaps, they have some cow products there inside. And what about the Indian soaps? Like we have so many Indian soaps.
Right.
Do they also contain animal fat inside?
Ramesh Prabhu, you know, Usha Mataji husband, he used to work in Mysore Sandal Soap Company. He mentioned that they also had some animal fat in it, vegetable oil, something. And he was worked for maybe 10 years there. And but even if they using or not using, our consciousness, that we indirectly support them if you buy with them. Even they are not using it, but we are supporting. If you buy these cow products, which is, it's called cow blessings or gover, so then it goes to our protecting of those cows. So in that way, that's the last way, it's a cheap way we are doing it, but that's the way we can do. The some answer is yes, some of things are not there, but you can take only cow products. So like that.
Thank Prabhuji,
yes.
Are you going to share these slides somehow?
Yes, sure, Prabhu.
Thank you.
On request, I'll send. Please send to an email to me. Everybody knows my mail. I can send the copy.
Okay, thank you.
More questions? And don't think this is very expensive and quantity is very less. And like that, you know, Krishna consciousness is nothing but volume. Right, I do 64 rounds chanting with a lot of nama bas. That's not helpful, right? Krishna consciousness is the quantity. The more how quantity you do, and even when we distribute the Srimad Bhagavatams, right, we knock the door, and we doesn't judge by looking at the people. We spend time, we'll explain them, and then they'll get faith. So, and people may say, oh, this Ahimsa milk is $25, I cannot buy, I have budget, I have this. Yes, everybody have their own problems, but when we joined Krishna consciousness, we left many things. I used to drink coffee on Ekadashi, I stopped it, right? So, like we used to have a onion and garlic in our childhood, and we come to a point that we only take prasadam now, Krishna prasad, and when we travel also, we carry prasad with them. So we compromise with many things. So why can't milk, You know, it's a simple thing. It's a daily thing we are taking it. Just you can take your own personal vow and follow the senior devotee's instructions. And by that, you'll feel it. You'll feel after 6 months, you'll himself feel by your personal motivation that I know I'm doing something for cows. So we put cows in the altar and worship him, but it doesn't help. And just because Krishna looking in detail, and when I think Keshavananda Prabhu said last week, we should also ask why, right? Why question? And without asking that, and we cannot feel it. And Krishna also won't be pleased by taking into if you consume any products. So, but it's up to your choice. I'm just sharing my views. Thank you, Hare Krishna. So, well, last two, any questions, protests, comments? Oh, Hari Guru Prabhu, yes. Prabhu, we have 1 minute, you can share. I asked for you are not here. I'll go to that slide. Sorry, Srivas Pandit Prabhu took my 15 minutes, so I'm using it now. So, okay. Hari Guru Prabhu is the director for this Surabhi Earthlink or farm we have. So he only spent more than actually is what our kids call him cowman. You know, so he spent all his time in the weekends roaming all on the farms, and he's having more realization than me. So he will talk about how we got the Surabhi into ISV. I have two slides for him, so you can just.
Please excuse me, I was away getting the milk from the farm today, so got delayed. There's heavy traffic on Route 17. So, I'm not sure. So, you want to know how we. Okay. How we started. So, maybe we can spare the story for another time, but just the detail was that. The farmer he introduced me to a person in Watsonville who used to have some cows in her home, and I spoke to that lady and I found out where she got the cows from, and she introduced me to a person who was working in Shock Dairy, John Shock Dairy. It's in Watsonville, and he's an employee. Michael Venuti is the name of the person who is the employee in John Shock Dairy, and he has information about, you know, he gives cows to people for their homes and to raise in countryside. They have that facility. So I called John Shock and I asked him, we are looking for a cow. If you know anyone who is looking to sell a cow, we might be interested in looking. So that's how he introduced us to a person in Prunedale, which is about 40 minutes further south of where the farm is. So I got in touch with them, and we had some tests done for the cow to make sure the health and the vaccination and everything is in place. And then once the paperwork was through, we made the arrangements at the farm to receive the cow. And a lot of effort from the farmer to ready the place, because this is totally new for him. He never had any cows on his farm. He has a few horses, but cow is a totally different thing, because you have to milk the cow, you have to care for the cow. Horses, you can leave them on the field and they'll mind their own business. But with cows, it's a very demanding occupation. And the farmer was really, you know, Krishna's arrangement that the farmer was willing to spend the time and energy for taking care of the cow and arranging for the milk to be delivered. So a lot of moving parts, and everyone has a role to play in this big project. So we start with one cow. And let's hope that we can make some progress on this. And thank you for the attention. And also, as Krishna Purusottama Prabhu was working out a little earlier, We are going to plan for maybe monthly or, you know, bi-monthly trips to the farm where devotees can come and see for real how much work is involved in taking care of the cows or what is involved in getting the milk to us and to feel the connection for this whole project and see who all are involved, to meet the people who are dealing with the cows and provide them little encouragement and motivation because they don't know why we are protecting cows. And right now they are just like employees and we are hiring them to take care of the cows. But we want it to be a little more deeper connection because we want them to know why we are interested in protecting cows and what's the significance of this. And that way we preach to them, we introduce Krishna consciousness to them in a practical manner. And you know, it's getting it into practice that's what makes the difference. And a few weeks ago there was a big festival on the farm for his community and there were hundreds of people and everyone was surprised to see the cow at the farm because this is the first time they're hearing of a cow at this farm. And I have a newsletter which the farmer sends out. Maybe some of you might have got it also, those who are the CSA members. So a lot of people were excited about the cow and they were really surprised pleasantly to find a cow at the farm. And some of them, to my surprise, were even aware of certain cow protection projects even in India and the US. And they were asking me about questions and I was like pleasantly surprised that the awareness is already there in the general population and we just have to take advantage of this opportunity and reach out to them in ways that that affect them at a much deeper level in their life, day-to-day activities also. So we would be requesting the devotees, welcoming the devotees to farm trips every now and then. We might be having one next Sunday as we announced during Govardhan Puja. So that way we get, right now the weather is nice, it hasn't started raining yet, so without any postponing it further, we should we welcome everyone to the farm trip. We might, we'll send out the details in the email in a coming one or two days, but it'll be helpful if we show our support to the farmer and his staff for taking care of the cow, and that way they feel motivated and to participate further in this project, because for them it's a totally different perspective. We have an opportunity to reach out to them and show them that there's a way to respect cows and treat cows differently. So it's a life-changing experience for them and we would like everyone's support in this transition for the farmer and his family and his staff to be there. We want to be there for him to answer his questions, to address his doubts, and to convince him and to show him that this is a better way of life. And with this one example, we can do miracles in and around Bay Area. And if we have a one working project, that's more than how many of our posters and words we can speak. With just one example, we can demonstrate the principles in practice. So we'll send out the email in one or two days. So please keep your calendars open for Sunday, November the 16th. And it's not the only chance. We'll do more trips in December, in January, maybe sometime in next summer also. It'll be really helpful for the community to come together in this project. Thank you.
So I want to answer that question. It's in my mind. Like, you know, Prabhupada wants everybody as an all-rounder. And he doesn't want only do deity worship, and he also wants to deity worship cow protection, and he also wants every devotee. He want to be as a multinational company, ISKCON, to present all devotees in all areas. And you know, that's why, you know, Vaisheshika Prabhu also, he does take only ahimsa milk, and he also does book dish. And all our maharajas or sannyasis, you see, they do all the programs of Prabhupada. So that's why I want to educate myself by doing this and purifying myself by presenting this presentation. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. So we also have a cow products outside. You can see Vinay Prabhu or Bhagavati Mataji. You want to enroll, we can get you the products. Hare Krishna.